off with the title fight. We're picking up with the title fight. This in the 147-pound division for our main portion of the card. Here at the Grizzly Rose for Sparta Combat League's Mile High Madness. Once again, I'm J.R. Gordon, joined by Colorado standout boxer Manny Perez. And we are welcoming our title contestant fighter, Mr. Alvaro, who's our to the ring right now. Crowd here this afternoon. Looks like another sellout for good timing on the camera work with that, guys. Just as I was saying, that looks like another sellout for us here. It's standing room only. Manny, these fight fans have been treated to some really good action this afternoon.
Absolutely. You know, there's been a lot of exciting fights to start the card, and it looks like it's going to be promising and finishing in the same fashion.
Absolutely. We've seen some go the distance. We've seen some a technical knockout, and just excitement all around.
Alvaro is another fighter trained by Hector Saez at the Bringing It Back Boxing. So he's got quite a few fighters out of his stable on the card. Alvaro is another exciting fighter, very aggressive, you know, throws with a lot of power. Looking to see if he's going to start the fight with a lot of the fireworks around him.
Wearing the gold trunks of a champion for his title fight.
And now, fighting out of the Blue Corps Shooting Center below corner, please make welcome Corey Madden.
And if you are a fan of boxers that work the body and they use that to slow down their opponents and pull ahead in a fight, you are in for something special watching Corey Madden, because this is a guy that just loves to tear up the body.
Hey, body work plays different ends in a match. It really does. Body shots are unforgiving. They are unforgiving. You get hit with a good body shot in round one, you will feel that till round 10. I guarantee it.
There's a reason they call it Money in the Bank. Work those body shots early on, pay some dividends, make a nice withdrawal later.
Fight number 6 of the evening is presented by the Ranch Restaurant in Greeley. Family owned and operated, serving American, Greek, Mexican food, a staple in Greeley and Northern Colorado, the Ranch Restaurant. It's now time to meet the elimination 147-pound fighters. First, fighting out of the Dynamic Mortgage Concepts Red Corner from Bring It Back Boxing in Denver, Colorado, please make welcome Alvaro Rezal. And now, fighting out of the Blue Corps Shooting Center Blue Corner, from Strictly Boxing in Denver, Colorado, please make welcome Corey Madden. This elimination 147-pound title bout is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. Referee, Tom Johnson.
All right, gentlemen, we went over the rules earlier. I want a clean, fair fight. Listen to me at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves if you like, and let's get after it.
Our final title fight of the afternoon before we get to the pro fighters. So nothing but action-packed from here on out. Huzar in the gold, Madden in the black.
Huzar already looking to establish that jab early on. Madden's already making his way on the inside.
And Madden throwing with power, looking to close that distance, plant his feet, land something devastating.
He came in with a lead left hook to the body that seemed to already stun Huzar. Definitely got his attention. Now he has him backpedaling.
Now he knows he's in a fight.
Going back to the body with that left hook. Madden is having a lot of success with that left hook to the body.
And having had the fortune of watching Mr. Madden do some work in the ring a number of times, I can tell you he's going to stay with that.
He is definitely not shy to take one to give one.
Huzar backed into the corner.
Huzar squared up on the ropes. Give him an opportunity to unload the combinations.
Corner of Huzar calling for more jabs.
I'm impressed in the body work that Madden's putting in. Lots of body shots.
Yeah, it's really how he makes his money, so to speak.
I'm telling you, they are unforgiving. Body shots are unforgiving. Got caught with a nice right hand, though, there by Huzar. Landed a nice right hand over the top.
Madden just continues to press forward, undaunted by the shots thrown by Huzar. 10-second clacker sounded.
There he goes, Madden, with another right hand landed.
Huzar looking to come over the top.
Oh, Madden closes that round strong.
Crowd's getting into it. Love it.
Madden closed that round really strong with the right hand to the top. He doesn't work behind the double jab enough, though. You know, he has nice, crisp body shots, does a lot of good work to the body, but nothing comes off the double jab. You know, he's basically earning every inch of what he has to get that body shot in. He's willing to take a shot to the head.
I was going
to
say, like you had referenced earlier, yeah, here we go on the replay, but like you had referenced earlier, willing to take a shot in order to get in as opposed to setting it up to get in. And here we see him fighting in a phone booth, keeping this fight close like a lot of it has been.
Yeah.
Madden up off his stool early, bouncing around, showing he's ready to go.
Of the two, he seems the better condition for
sure.
Yeah,
and a little bit of a psychological tactic there, just showing your opponent, hey, I'm ready to go, and you're still sitting there trying to get some water.
Absolutely. Trust me, when you take a peek over and your opponent is still standing up already ready to go, it'll definitely break you down just a tad. Alvaro's trying to stay on the outside now, trying to work from, you know, being the taller fighter, he's trying to stay on the outside, work that jab, stay long and rangy. Madden is still effective to the body, though.
Yeah, not a bad strategy to employ by Huzar. Try to keep it at range, keep Madden from being able to get those body shots in.
The only thing that I would change with Madden is I would change his aggressiveness and his approach towards fighting. Just add that jab, work in behind the double jab to get to the body. Because he finds a lot of success on the inside, but he's just willing to take too many punches to get there.
Rough way to make a living.
Tough way to make a living. Right now he knows that he's the stronger man. He's pressing, he's applying his pressure. He's breaking him down mentally just by sheer pressure. Then you add those body shots to it. You know, he's won the fight already.
Yeah, it can be demoralizing, especially, you know,
absolutely.
You hit him with a strong shot, and his answer is to not back up or not show it, but he hits you back with something even harder.
And he shows no emotion. Madden gets caught with the shot, shows no emotion, goes back to grinding away. He's a grinder.
And again, psychological warfare.
Absolutely.
We both know you just hit me hard, I'm just not going to show it.
Alvaro just got caught with a straight shot by Madden. He crosses his feet a lot in there. He's moving, he's trying to be elusive with his footwork, but he crosses his feet and ends up getting tangled up himself. It's not really stable there. Got caught with another right hand over the top by Madden. Madden just pressing the action, breaking him down.
He's got that
Mickey Ward type style. Yeah. Got that Mickey Ward type style.
Good call.
You know, very aggressive, a lot of body punches, willing to eat a shot to take, you know, to gain one. Alvaro is truly just gassed, both physically and mentally, he's looking like, you know? If I was in Alvaro's corner right now, I would not have let him sit on that stool.
Yeah, and here we see on the replay, again, just working in close, working the body shots, occasionally brings him up to the head. Nice job by Madden of mixing the level of his punches, keep his opponent wondering what's going on.
Madden is just really able to apply his will at any moment of this fight. And he's taking advantage of it. He's capitalizing on it.
Absolutely. There he goes. End of the round.
Absolutely.
We see Madden up in his corner waiting for his opponent to try to gather himself off the stool.
By far the better condition of the two. He's showing it here. And he's just the one with the, you know, just more honed in on his game plan and what he wants to do in that ring. I would just add the jab. Everything should come behind the jab. You know, the jab to get into the body, start with those body shots, left hook to the head. Madden looking to close the show, starting off aggressively with straight shots. Back to the body again. That left hook to the body has been Madden's bread and butter in the past three rounds.
Past three fights, actually.
Now he switches left-handed just momentarily.
Yeah, Madden just in stalking mode now. Yeah.
Momentarily switched to the southpaw stance for a moment. Then went back to the right-hand stance.
Sweat flies from that shot by Huszar. And again, Huszar over the top with a nice, tight right hook.
Alvaro trying to hold his ground a little bit more. Trying to make Madden pay for coming in to close range.
Good stiff jab by Huszar.
Huszar's trying to come back. He's making a comeback.
He's got
a very, very crisp right hand. Got the crowd into it. The crowd's feeling it. He's definitely trying to work, instill his will now.
Nice forward pressure by Huszar, especially at the end of a fight where you know he's feeling gassed out. Good job by the bring it back boxing fighter, but the 10-second clock has sounded, and Madden's back in the stalking mode.
It's Madden on the press right now. You know, you could have gave that round to Huszar, but you're still down 2-1. You know, I give this fight to Madden with the aggressive body punching and the effective pressure.
Agreed. And Madden has been in his previous fights just not willing to take a step backward. On top of his technical precision, his great body punching game, he's just a super tough man.
Yeah, I was impressed with his body work. Like I said, I would just add the jab to his arsenal, work behind the jab. I think he'd find more success that way as well. And then just less wear and tear on his own body. I'd say he's too willing to take those shots coming, making his way in.
Checking out the replay here. This is Huszar putting together a few jabs like you've been calling for, and we can see it pays off for him. It makes Madden have to adjust his game a little bit. But Madden, again, willing to just bite down on the mouthpiece and throw hard.
Huszar found better success when he pressed the action. He just didn't press the action enough.
Yes, sir. So we'll see if the judges see it the same way that you and I do. Since, well, our opinion counts for nothing. And again on the replay, we see Madden mixing the levels of his punches here. As much as we talked about his body punching game, he used that to set up some good headshots as well.
He landed some good right hooks to the head.
And we'll take it up to Sean for the official word.
After three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. All three judges scored the bout 29-28, declaring your winner by unanimous decision. And still Sparta Combat League 147-pound champion, Corey Madden!
Congratulations to the Strictly Boxing fighter, Corey Madden, retains his title and gets a shiny new red belt to go home with. Not a bad start to the weekend.
That was a good win for him. Huszar was a tough fighter, came in game. He just applied his game.
First of all, my apologies to Corey, because you're not still the champion. You're the new champion in this weight division. Down a few pounds to come down from 152 to 147. How'd it feel?
Felt good. I knew I could make the weight. It wasn't a big issue, but it's definitely the lowest I've been since high school.
What was the big key in this one for you?
Just fight, man. Just do what I was told to.
It works out well for you now. Two division champion, thinking about going pro anytime soon?
I think so.
Looking forward to that for sure. Some people you want to thank, big crowd out here for you.
All my friends and family, my coaches, Nick and Rick, DNN Motorsports, Hydrodynamic, Do or Die Salon, Alpine Electrical. Just thanks for coming out, everyone.
Congratulations. Another belt for him. Give it up for Corey Madden.
Good victory for Corey Madden.
Back with the co-main event in a moment.